Today, our subject matter is electrophoresis. This is for second year zoology honor students. And according to the syllabus of University of Gaurbongo, this is under fourth paper, unit 2. At first, we have to know what is electrophoresis. Electrophoresis is an electrokinetic process which separates charged particles in a fluid using a field of electrical charge. It is most often used to separate protein molecules or DNA and can be achieved through several different procedures depending on types and size of molecule. In other words, electrophoresis is the migration of charged particles or molecules under the influence of electric current. That is, when there is no electric field generated, the ions move haphazardly, but when there is an electric field applied, the negatively charged ions move towards the positive pole and the positively charged ion move towards the negative pole. When an electric field is applied or generated, there is two kind of forces operating in opposite direction, that is friction force and electrophoretic retardation force, that is operating backwardly, and the electrostatic force that is operating towards the electric field, towards the direction of electric field rather. The electrostatic force helps the molecules to move forward. The ionic cloud is mobile, that is, in the supporting medium, the positively charged ions move towards the cathode, that is the negative pole, and the greater the charge of the molecule, the greater the force applied by the electrical field, and therefore the molecule will move relative to its mass through the supporting medium. Electrical current causes a positive ionic cloud to move toward the cathode, that is negatively charged pole. The supporting medium here is the buffer. Buffer is used to provide ions that carry a current and to maintain the pH at a relatively constant value. The most common buffer in electrophoresis for nucleic acid is tris acetate EDTA, that is TAE. EDTA is ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, that is a chelating agent. Supporting medium is also a matrix in which the protein separation takes place. Various type has been used for the separation either on slab or on capillary form. Separation is based on to the charge to mass ratio of protein depending on the pore size of the medium, possibly the molecular size. The types of concern, that is in your syllabus, there are two types. In spite of these two types, there are other types also, but here we consider the main two types, that is agarose gel electrophoresis and polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. Agarose gel is easy to cast. It is commonly used for electrophoresis of DNA. It has a large pore structure allowing larger molecules to move easily, but it is not suitable for sequencing smaller molecules. But in case of polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, that is PAGE, has a clear resolution than agarose gel, making it more suitable for quantitative analysis. It can also be used to develop the understanding of how bacteria is becoming resistant to antibiotics through plasmid analysis. Gel electrophoresis is a technique used to separate DNA fragments according to their size or length. DNA samples are loaded into wells at one end of a gel and an electric current is applied to pull them through the gel. We should remember that DNA fragments are negatively charged, so they move toward the positive electrode, that is the anode. Here, the wells where DNA sample is injected into the gel. The gel electrophoresis can separate DNA fragments of different length, that is, the larger length DNA moves slowly, but the smaller length move swiftly to reach the positive electrode, that is anode. Agar is a mixture of polysaccharide extracted from seaweeds. Agarose is a highly purified uncharged polysaccharide derived from agar. Agarose is chemically basic disaccharide repeating unit of 3,6 anhydro L galactose. The pore size may be predetermined by adjusting the concentration of agarose in the gel. Agarose gel are fragile. Gel is actually colloid in a solid form. The gel material acts as a molecular sieve. The pores of an agarose gel are large. Agarose is used to separate macromolecules such as nucleic acids. The polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, that is PAGE, is widely used to separate biological macromolecules, usually protein, nucleic acid, according to their electrophoretic mobility. Electrophoretic mobility is a function of length, conformation, and charge of the molecule. It is a powerful tool to analyze RNA samples. Here, the sample loading is done in the wells, and this is the direction of migration to the anode. The protein mixture of different sizes move through the porous gel, and after electrophoresis we can find that the smallest molecules reach the opposite end, but the molecules with middle size have not reached the target, and the molecules of large size cannot move conveniently. The principle PAGE, that is polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, is working upon the principle in which the charged molecule will migrate towards the oppositely charged electrode through highly cross-linked matrix. Separation occurs due to different rates of migration by magnitude of charge and frictional resistance related to the size. So here the relative mobility, that is V, is equal to E into Q by F. E is equal to the voltage applied, Q is equal to the charge of the molecule, and F is the frictional resistance. Any charged ion or molecule migrates when placed in an electric field. The rate of migration depends upon its net charge, size, shape, and the applied electric current. If we consider the SDS page, the SDS, that is the sodium dodecyl sulfate page, polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis, then we can notice the samples which contain the single subunit folded protein with charge and protein with two subunits, that is B and C, are heated with SDS, that is an anionic detergent that denatures secondary and non-disulfide linked tertiary structure and applies a negative charge to each protein in proportion to its mass. When it is applied in the wells of the stacking gel, here two very important points are there, that is stacking gel and resolving gel. The stacking gel is needed to pack all the proteins in one band, so they will start migrating in the running gel all at the same time. But resolving gel is a gel with higher concentration. It is for the improvement of the resolution of the electrophoresis. So after loading, the electrophoresis starts through the buffer. Proteins are separated based on their polypeptide chain length by electrophoresis in a polyacrylamide gel with an appropriate mesh size. That is, protein with high molecular weight moves slowly and protein with low molecular weight moves swiftly towards the anode site. Polyacrylamide that is used in PAGE are formed from the polymerization of monomer in presence of small amount of NN methylene bisacrylamide. Bisacrylamide is two acrylamide linked by the methylene group. The polyacrylamide chain or the polymerization of the acrylamide is an example for free radical catalysis. They are defined in terms of total percentage of acrylamide present and pore size vary with concentration. Application. The application of electrophoresis includes estimation of DNA molecules, that is, gel electrophoresis can separate DNA molecules or DNA fragments of different lengths. So agarose as well as PAGE is used to estimate the DNA molecules. Analysis of PCR product, that is polymerase chain reaction product. Separation of restricted genomic DNA and RNA. Here agarose and PAGE is used respectively. Confirmation of newly isolated DNA, that is done by agarose gel electrophoresis. Separation of most small fragments of DNA, that is done by PAGE, because this is small fragments and the resolution of Page is high. In forensic science, agarose, page, SDS page, 2D, that is two-dimensional page, capillary gel electrophoresis are used. In determining molecular weight of protein, SDS page is used. So this is the application of electrophoresis, and we can use this process hugely. So students, I hope you understand the whole process. That's all for today. Thank you.